We have with us Dr. Rajiv Kumar Gupta, the MD of the company. Thanks so much for joining in, Dr. Gupta. Always a pleasure talking to you. Well, let's start off with TDI pricing. Now, Sheila Foam, they're expecting a sharp correction from here in terms of TDI pricing. Even global supplies have picked up. What is the TDI pricing outlook according to you and expected average TDI pricing for the remainder of this fiscal?
See, one very clear statement I would like to make that I don't see the prices softening too much as far as the domestic prices is concerned. Domestic prices, we have been selling around 300,000 rupees for the last around 1 year with 5 to 7% plus or minus. I don't see those prices going drastically down, 5 to 10,000 rupees depending on the imports. Additional capacities that have come up is only in Sadara, and Sadara lending prices are also about 285 to 290,000 in terms of Indian rupees. Exports, yes, definitely there has been a correction of about $200 to $300. But then, as far as GNFC is concerned, we have diverted more of our supplies to domestic demand, and we have been supplying more than 125 tons a day to our domestic customers. So, at the same time, we are also having substantial export orders in our hand. So, overall, I don't see in the world market also a very substantial price correction, as probably you have said, you have named a company they are thinking. Covestro MD on 20th of June has also issued a statement that Sadara supplies have been absorbed by the market. So even Covestro also does not see the prices falling down because of additional supplies.
So we take your point that, you know, you don't see the prices to go much lower from here. The street is hearing what you're saying. But in the meanwhile, if you could also tell us, what is the base level of these TDI prices? Give us some base level.
I don't see the prices going below 250.
And what's the geographic mix of the company currently?
Well, as far as GNFC is concerned, we have opened up new markets. We are exporting to 31 countries in Africa, 11 countries in Latin America and South America, which were non-existent earlier. And in TDI, you have to take into account these new markets, which were hitherto unknown. So exports, we are now catering to these regions in addition to our traditional exports to Middle East and Asia Pacific. Domestically, see, we are making roughly 225 tons per day. So in any case, since the anti-dumping duty is in operation, so we are bound to supply the domestic market to the maximum extent possible, and we are getting a better price realization. So our target is just about 100 tons exports per day and about 125 tons to 150 tons per day for the domestic market. We want to satisfy every domestic consumer because we are duty bound to do that.
Okay, all right, Dr. Gupta. So you're saying that in fact domestic pricing is better, and that's the focus area as well. But let's talk about the EBITDA per ton. If you could give us some sense, what could be the EBITDA per ton? What was it in the last year? What is it likely to be in this year? Because prices have come off, right, a tad bit from the top.
Well, again, I mean, these are price sensitive information, Nigel, but I can say, I can tell you that our profit margins are consistent.
All right, okay, well, we get that point. But sir, we understand that in China, acetic acid has soared to the highest price in a decade on account of tight supply. GNFC, we understand, is the largest producer of this acetic acid. So what's the outlook there on the acetic acid prices?
GNFC is not the largest producer in India. GNFC is the only producer in India. India consumes 1 million tons of acetic acid, of which 159,000 tons of acetic acid is produced in India, and that too alone by GNFC. Acetic prices over the last 1 year have seen an upward trend of almost 40%, and we don't see any new capacities coming up till 2022 in the world. So acetic prices for now are going to be consistent and pretty high.
Okay, all right. Dr. Gupta, GNFC is virtually debt-free. You've told us that numerous times. What is the CapEx plan? Now you're going to have free cash flows. So what are you going to use it for?
See, at one point of time, we had an interest burden of almost 450 crores per year that was brought down to 200 crores. And since last financial year, we are a long-term debt-free company. And as on today, we are even a working capital-free company. So we have neither the long-term debt nor a working capital exposure. So in that case, anything between 100 to 200 crores, we are going to save on interest costs. As far as utilization of this cash accrual is concerned, the board has already decided for expansion in acetic acid, formic acid, ammonia, and concentrated nitric acid. And these all four are very, very strong areas where GNFC is a market leader. We are also going in for a capacity expansion in our neem segment, ramping our capacities of soap production, hand wash production, face wash production. So all of these cash accruals we are planning to utilize for our own capacity expansion plans.
Well, Dr. Gupta, last time you told us about bidding for RCF's formic acid plant. Is there any update on that front, GNFC bidding for that plant?
There are some technical and administrative issues in RCF, so we have decided to go ahead with our own 7,000 to 8,000 tons capacity expansion in formic acid.
And what about the joint venture with Ecofos? When will it get commissioned?
Well, I can tell you about the progress made so far. The financial closure has been achieved, and engineering designs are almost complete. The contractor has been selected and appointed, and the groundwork on the site is going to start immediately after the rains. Fabrication and the machinery will not take much time because most of it is going to come from the joint venture partner. So, max in about 1.5 year time from now, the project should be on ground and operational.
All right, final question, Dr. Gupta, before we let you go. The Neem project, that's been really the pet project. How is growth shaping up there? What has been your reach? Is there any expansion on that front?
Yes, Honorable Prime Minister, decision of 100% neem coating of urea has allowed immense possibilities of employment generation and expansion. And Neem project has been benefiting 4.5 lakh women by way of almost 45 crores of income to them. Going on forward integration, yes, now we are expanding our distribution network. 25,000 shops are selling the Neem products. Bulk marketing channels like Big Bazaar, Star Bazaar, Central Defense Canteen, Central Police Canteen, Kendriya Bhandars, they are being roped in. And we are also now gradually launching the publicity campaign, the media campaign. We've started with the radio jingle. Soon we'll be coming out with TV commercials. So gradually this Neem segment is going to grow. And definitely, as I have earlier said in your channel only, that we plan to achieve, our ambitious target is to achieve about 500 crores turnover by 2020.
All right. Thanks a lot, sir, for joining in and giving us all those updates. An ambitious target as far as the Neem project is concerned. But Nigel, as an FMCG analyst for me,